हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल बियॉन्ड स्टॉक्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मेरी क्रिसमस टू वन एंड ऑल. आई होप यू एंजॉय दिस पर्टिकुलर डे. सो टुडे वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ टॉपिक व्हिच इज 25 स्टॉक्स फॉर नेक्स्ट 25 इयर्स. सो इफ यू लाइक दिस पर्टिकुलर कंटेंट, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल फॉर सच इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्टेंट. एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू कैन कमेंट एंड लाइक एज वेल. सो लेट अस सी वॉट वी हैव इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो इज बेस्ड ऑन मोतीलाल ओसवाल्स 25th एनुअल वेल्थ क्रिएशन स्टडी. In this particular video, we will be telling you about Motilal Oswal's research, wherein they take into consideration 25 years and they talk about top 25 companies who are the wealth creators and the bottom 25 companies who are the wealth destroyers for shareholder. They also tell about the top 25 futuristic company in which shareholders can invest their money and which might do good in future. So we will be covering this particular report and telling you about the top 25 wealth destroyers, wealth creators, and wealth consistent companies which are there in future. Out of the top 500 companies, only 100 companies have outperformed the index of Sensex, which tells us that it is very difficult to stay consistent over the long period of time. So there are companies which might do good in short term, but these companies might not do good in the long term because the companies have to be consistent in their earnings, their revenues, as well as their profit after tax. This is how they can give a good CAGR to the shareholders which invest in these particular companies. So it's very difficult to be very consistent in the market for if we talk about 25 years of period. So as I talked about, it's very difficult to stay consistent in the future. Along with that, past is not guarantee of the future. So the past, the companies which did good in the past might not do good in the future. So you have to take a calculative decision based on a certain research and certain fundamentals as well of that particular company or business which you are holding. So at last, we will also be going to we'll also share with you the 25 companies which might do good in future, according to the Motilal Oswal report. So let's see the further slides.
Let's now discuss about the top 25 fastest wealth creators in the last 25 years. So from the top 500 companies that were there in 1995, we will see which companies created the fastest wealth in next 25 years. So at the top, we have Infosys, which has grown at a CAGR of 30%, whose share price has grown at the rate of 30% CAGR. And it would have multiplied your wealth by 688 times in the last 25 years. That means if in 1995, you would have invested 1,000 rupees in Infosys, today its value will be 1,000 into 688. That is, in 25 years. And also there are a list of other companies which are fast. At second, we have Pidilite, we have Eicher Motors, and there are a list of lot of stocks here. And if you want to get a list of all of this, there is a PDF link in the comment section, as well as this description section. So that consists of the wealth research study by the Motilal Oswal itself. So you can also go through that for detailed analysis of all these stocks. Now also one thing to note here is that you will see a correlation between stock price CAGR and profit after tax CAGR. So if you see, for example, Infosys stock price grew at 30% CAGR, and their profits grew at 33% CAGR. So if you see in the long term, stock price is related to the earnings, like how much companies able to grow their earnings. For example, you can check for others also. Pidilite, if you see, their share price grew at 25% CAGR. Their earnings grew at 20% CAGR. So both are close to each other. For others also, you can see Sun Pharma, Eicher Motors, all share price and earnings are quite related to each other. So only the stocks which can grow their earnings in the long term, they only become the biggest wealth creator in the long term. And also other thing to note is that if you see all these companies have a very good ROE, return on equity. For example, most of these companies, if you see, have a return to equity greater than 20% at least. Most of them, I'm not telling every company, but most of them, they are close to 20% or higher than 20%. And that's how wealth is created over long term. Good return on equity and good profit growth over long term.
So as we saw the top 25 fastest wealth creators, here we will see at top 25 consistent wealth creators from 1995 to 2020. That is a period of 25 years. So if we see the top first rank, which is Kotak Mahindra Bank. So out of these 25 years, Kotak Mahindra Bank has beaten 21 times Sensex benchmark, which is there. So in the last 25 years, Kotak Mahindra Bank has beaten 21 times out of 25 years. And Berger Paints, they have beaten 20 times out of the 25 years. So they've been very consistent in giving shareholders their profit, or being very consistent by giving good CAGR to the shareholders. So these are the top 25 consistent wealth creators in the share market. So year two, in the long run, if we see the last 25-year PAT CAGR and 25-year price CAGR, they both are quite related to each other. Not much difference which we can see here. Like if Kotak Mahindra Bank, 25-year price CAGR was 21% and 25-year PAT, like profit after tax CAGR, is 22%. Like it's quite related to each other. So if the company performs good in terms of earnings, that is profit after tax, and they get good revenue, then they will naturally perform good in terms of price as well. So this is something which we have observed from our end. Apart from that, if we see ROE, that is return on equities, most of the companies which are 25, the 25 most companies which are consistent wealth creators for shareholders, they have ROE greater than 20%. So naturally, ROE and price as well as PAT, that's profit after tax, goes hand in hand. And these are some factors which makes a company consistent in performance. As we've seen, the top 25 fastest growth companies as well as top 25 consistent growth companies for shareholders, let us look at the top 25 companies in 1995 whose 25-year CAGR was lower than that of Sensex. So basically, these top 25 companies did not perform good, and these were wealth destroyers for the shareholders. So if we see the first one, that is SAIL, as per market capitalization, it had rank one. It has the highest market capitalization, but its price decreased by 2% in the last 25 years, and it was a wealth destroyer for shareholders. Its profit after tax was also quite less. That is only 3%, which was very less. If we see the companies which were consistent, their PAT was quite higher than this. Apart from that, we see a lot of Tata companies here. If you check out the list, there's Tata Motors, that is, there's Tata Communication, Tata Chemicals, Tata Consumers. So Tata companies, all in all, did not perform that good as expected. But as we see now, we have Chandrasekhar sir. So after he joining the company, the Tata companies have improved to a very good extent. And we might see good improvement in the prices in this particular year or in the next 25 years. So that is why we cannot decide past performance of the company. If we can't relate the past performance to the future performance of that particular company, we have to do the present analysis and the future scope or future perspective of that particular company or their futuristic business or ideas which they have. So here we get a good lesson out from here.
So now we will look at 25 companies that can potentially create a lot of wealth in the next 25 years. And as we have seen, like, past is not a guarantee of future. That's why we will look at present data and decide like which companies can be wealth creators. Like Motilal Oswal report, like they have mentioned about like 9 points on how they have decided that these companies, these 25 companies, can create the wealth. Like I will discuss some of the criteria there. Like in terms of size, they have taken only a list of 150 mid caps, like the companies which are ranked from 101 to 250 in the current market cap. Then they have taken some companies out of this, like, if you see, like, they have only taken consumer facing companies into consideration. Like they have removed the companies which are cyclical in nature, like auto ancillaries, capital goods, chemicals, oil and gas, and real estate. These companies they have removed from this list, because most of these companies, if you see, even in the top 25 wealth creator, fastest wealth creator or consistent wealth creator, these companies from this sector are very less. I mean, most companies are the companies which are consumer facing. Then they have also looked at profitability, like which companies are very profitable. Like we already discussed, like companies which have ROE greater than 20%, but here they have taken a cutoff of 15%, like company whose ROE at current is greater than 15%. They also have looked at the management, like how good is the management of the company. Then they have looked at the market leadership, like which companies are markets in their sectors. They have only selected those companies. They have also looked at some other important points other than these fundamental points. Like they have looked at value migration. Like today, a lot of value migration is happening. For example, you can take example of banks. Like if you look at 25 years before, most of the market, like in the bank, was with the public sector companies. But that is changing slowly, slowly. The share of private companies in the banking is increasing year by year. So that's also they are looking at value migration. Then they are also looking. They have also made a very important point. large cap for financial. What this means is, see, financial is a very risky bet. All the financial companies, banks, they are very risky. You would have seen a lot of banks being almost shut down, right? Government have been coming and they, I mean, so this is a list of 25 stocks for next 25 years for from Motilal Oswal research report. So you can see some companies are from pharma, like Ajanta Pharma, Alembic Pharma. There are many financial players like HDFC AMC, HDFC Bank, HDFC Life Insurance, ICICI companies like ICICI Lombard, ICICI Securities. You have many other companies also here like Bata, Bajaj Finance and many others. So you can go through all the list, like 25 companies here. But this is also an important disclaimer at the bottom that these companies are not like the recommendation from their side. Like Motilal Oswal Group may have financial interest in many of these companies. And that's why they would have recommended you. That may also happen. So that's why it's better to do your own research on these companies. Like if you also feel that, yes, these companies can create the wealth for next 25 years, and then take your decision whether you want to invest or not invest.
So this particular video was Motilal's research report, which consisted of the top 25 stocks for next 25 years, which we covered today. So let us know your thoughts. What do you think would be the best company as per you in the next 25 years? You can comment below on this particular video. We would love to know your thought as well. Also, if you like this particular video and the content, do share it with your friends, like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Bye.